Kia ora and welcome to Thankyou Payroll. In this video, we're going to show you how to set up a new employee profile. Before you go any further, you'll need the following information handy: your employee's name, their IRD number, bank account number, employment start date, email address, tax code, pay rate, KiwiSaver contribution rate, details of their leave entitlements, and pay history. Move your cursor to the Employees menu from the top of your dashboard and click on Add New Employee to start the process. For the purpose of this video, we're going to be using an employee that's already been set up. The first page of the employee profile is the basic details page, which includes things like the employee's name, IRD number, start date, bank account details, and email address for payslips. Once you've filled out all of this information, you can hit Save and Next at the bottom of the page to move on to the standard pay section. This is where you enter your employee's pay rate, how they are paid, their tax code, details of any regular working hours, and there are a few extra options for tracking for Xero if you have your Xero account integrated with your Thankyou Payroll account, and special student loan settings, which you'll only need to look at if IRD have sent you or your employee a letter asking them to make extra student loan deductions. The main part of this page is the pay information. This example employee is paid $19 an hour and they regularly work 5 hours a day, Monday through Friday. So this can save you a bit of time. Popping their hours in here will mean that whenever you add them to a pay, these hours will appear in their timesheet and you can then make any changes necessary. Once you've filled out everything on this page, you can hit Save and Next to move on to the pay type section. This is where you can set up custom pay types for your employee. For instance, if you need to pay them a bonus or an allowance, you can set up a custom pay type here, which allows you to choose the name, set the rate, and then choose how the rate is calculated. Please note that there are two sections in the pay types tab: the normal pay types and allowances, taxed, and non-taxable pay types and allowances. So do make sure to set your pay types up in the correct section. You can then hit Save and Next at the bottom of the page to move on to the KiwiSaver and child support details. If your employee is in KiwiSaver, at a minimum, both you and them need to contribute 3%. You can pop the contribution percentages in these boxes here. You'll also need to select an ESCT rate. ESCT stands for Employer Superannuation Contribution Tax and is applicable when KiwiSaver is involved. As it says here, you need to select a rate based on your best guess of your employee's yearly income. So if you're really not sure, your best guess is fine. There are some advanced settings for KiwiSaver. In some situations, some employees' KiwiSaver employer contributions are included as part of their gross wage. If you think this is the case for your employee, feel free to get in touch with us so we can help you set that up. If your employee has child support deductions, you can enter the contribution amount per pay. And if they use a superannuation complying fund that is not KiwiSaver, you can enter the details in this section here. Once you've filled out all the necessary details on this page, hit Save and Next. The Leave section is where things can start to get a bit tricky. It's helpful to have your employee's employment contract on hand, as that's the source document for their leave entitlements. If you know how your employee's leave needs to be set up, but you're unsure how to do it in the system, you're more than welcome to give the help desk an email or give us a call on 0800 895 146 between 10 and 5 on business days. You can also see the annual leave help page. And if you're unsure about what your contract says about your employees' leave entitlements, do get in touch with the Labour Department, also known as Employment New Zealand. as they're qualified to offer that advice. Unfortunately, we are not, but once you've got that sorted out, we can show you how to set it up in the system. There are multiple different leave methods you can choose from. A percentage of gross earnings, as it says here, is generally used for temporary and irregular employees. Rate set as per the Holidays Act, which means annual leave, and included in existing pay rates, don't pay, which is generally used for contractors with no leave entitlements. This example employee is set up on rate set as per the Holidays Act or annual leave. They're entitled to 4 weeks of leave per year, and the length of a standard week has been set to the same as the default standard week loaded in their standard pay settings, which is again 5 days a week, 5 hours a day, resulting in 25 hours in a typical week. Moving down the page, you have the annual leave anniversary and initial values. The leave anniversary should be set to your employee's start date. If your employee already has an allocated days balance at the point they are moved into Thankyou Payroll, you can enter that balance in days in this box. The last box, the date of the most recent edition of leave before using Thankyou Payroll, should be set to the employee's most recent leave anniversary. All of the values here are set to the minimum legal entitlements laid out in the Holidays Act, 5 days of sick leave per year, a maximum balance of 20 sick leave days at any one time, and 20 days that can be carried over from one allocation to the next. Of course, if your employee gets more than these, you can change these values. If they have an existing balance at the time they come into Thankyou Payroll, you can enter this balance in days in this box. And the date of the most recent edition of sick leave before using Thankyou Payroll should be set to their most recent sick leave anniversary. Towards the bottom of the page, you have space to enter any alternative days or time in lieu owing to them, again, entered in days. And on the right-hand side, the option to toggle on or off their leave balances on their payslips. Once you've finished with this section, you can hit Save and Next at the bottom to move on to the History section. The History section is where you can enter your employee's historical pay information. There are two reasons you may need to do this. The first is that you're joining Thankyou Payroll partway through a month, and you have already made payments to your employee outside of Thankyou Payroll during this month. IRD only accepts filing from one entity, so we need all of the payment history for a given month in order to file your IR345 and 348 employer monthly returns. You'll need to enter your employee's history as far back as the first pay made within this month, including the gross, net, PAYE, and any other deductions such as KiwiSaver, child support, student loan, and so on. Each of the relevant details can be entered by pay period in the boxes here. The filing team will then get in touch with you to help with the process of transferring the required amount to Thankyou Payroll so we can file the return for you. The second reason you may need to enter history is if your employee has an accruing annual leave balance. You'll need to enter their payment history as far back as their most recent leave anniversary. This is because our system calculates annual leave at 8% of the employee's total gross wages. If you're entering the history solely for the purpose of calculating the leave balance, we only need the gross amount for each pay period dating back to their most recent leave anniversary. Once you have entered all the relevant history information, you can hit Save and Next at the bottom to move on to the next page. The employee contact details and reference codes are optional and are just used for internal purposes, so you may or may not want to enter anything on this page. The next section is fines and payments, where you can set up payments to the Ministry of Justice, as well as payments to alternative employee bank accounts. The Ministry of Justice fine payment section is only to be used for payments to the Ministry of Justice. They should provide a 10-digit PPN number, which you can enter here, then the total amount of the fine, and the amount to be repaid each pay. If you're unsure as to whether or not the fine is a Ministry of Justice fine, please get in touch with the help desk before loading. The second section here allows you to split your employee's pay into a separate bank account. The nominated amount will go into the nominated bank account here, and the remainder will go into the bank account that you've entered in the basic details section of their employee profile. As it says here, the option is only for dividing payments to personal accounts and should not be used to pay organizations like work and income. We can't accept any liability whatsoever for a loss of funds transferred to such organizations using this section. The reason it doesn't work is because payments made using this facility don't carry any reference details that allows third-party organizations to identify who the payment is from. The final section is payroll giving. If your employee wants to donate part of each of their pays to a charity, they can type the charity's name into this box, and if it's available, they can select the charity and then enter an amount to donate per pay. Once you're finished with this section, your employee is ready to go and you're able to load them into a pay on your dashboard.